Hello everyone, IceCool Tech here. Now Apple has just released watchOS 10.1 to the public, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at performance, battery life, and any bugs that may or may not have been fixed. Anyways, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe with the button down below if you haven't already for more content just like this in the future. Anyways, I don't want to waste any extra time, so let's just get straight into it. Now, performance with watchOS 10.1 has actually been quite a bit better than on previous watchOS 10 updates for me. I noticed this immediately after updating, where apps launch a little bit faster and content loads faster as well. Now, animations have also been much improved within watchOS 10.1, where I no longer experience stuttering when scrolling through widgets or the home screen. Now, battery life on my Apple Watch Series 6 has been the same as watchOS 10.0 for me, and that's horrific. I have to charge every day, typically right before I go to sleep, which is very frustrating when you sleep track. Now keep in mind that my max capacity on my Series 6 is 82%. However, keep in mind that though this capacity is low and likely contributing to this drain, other people with similar Apple Watch models have reported very similar results with much higher battery capacities. Now, as for my Apple Watch Ultra, before watchOS 10.1, I could definitely get through 2 full days without a charge. However, I would just make it over. Now with 10.1, I'm easily able to make it over a full 2 days without charging it a single time. So definitely some nice improvements there. Now as for bug fixes, Apple has not listed any in the watchOS 10.1 release notes. Users with Apple Watch Series 9 and Ultra models should not expect to see a fix for the intense display dimming within this update, as many are still experiencing it after updating. Other than that, nothing has really changed. So that is watchOS 10.1. Do I recommend updating? It depends. If you're on an earlier version of watchOS 10, I would definitely recommend updating, since there are definitely improvements with performance and a little bit of extra battery life as well. If you're on an earlier version of maybe watchOS 9, I would hold off a little bit longer, maybe to watchOS 10.2 release or even 10.3, if you're not sure whether or not to update due to battery life or bugs, because there still could be, you know, a significant improvement over what we currently have. So that's watchOS 10.1. Thank you all for watching. If you did enjoy this video or found it helpful in any way, show me with a like down below. Of course, as always, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you're new. Anyways, thank you all for watching. I'll see you in the next one.